Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And have you ever thought about which is faster? A slicer on the report page, custom slicer panel, or using the filter pane? Well, in this video, I'm gonna show you. Stay tuned. Slice, yeah. Find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right, let me give you a little context before we get into this. Johnny over at Grayscale Analytics posted a poll out on Twitter and he asks, do you hide the filter pane on your Power BI reports? Now this sparked lots of conversation, lots of comments, which then led to him writing a great blog post on should you hide your filter pane in Power BI. And he goes through and explains, and even references the custom slicer panel video that Adam did on our YouTube channel. But there's a really nice comment from Carrie Colosco where she says, nope, I advise people to use it pretty much because they enforce consistency. If I have multiple developers developing custom filter panes, it could be very inconsistent and challenging for my report consumers. If I misspoke, let me know, you know, hit me up. And then this led to a comment by Ed Hansberry, an MVP. He's like, well, regardless of which one we pick, which one is faster? And he posted a comment, he tagged me and he was like, Patrick, go do some testing. So here we are to do some testing. So I came up with about 9 scenarios and I'm gonna do some performance evaluation of these. These are the best ones I could think of and it's probably not an exhaustive list. All right, so enough of all this talking. You guys know what I like to do? Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. The very first scenario is just a normal slicer list on a page. You will notice a pattern that I'm going to do with each one of these scenarios. So the first thing I'm going to do is go to external tools, launch DAX Studio, and I'm going to turn on all queries. This will be the same pattern for every one of the scenarios. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to float that particular page. So let's get rid of DAX Studio. And then what I'm going to do is go to view, turn on performance analyzer, start recording. You can see I have my empty or my blank page. And then I'm just gonna switch. I'm gonna head over to this page. It just contains some slicers. You can see that Performance Analyzer picked it up and some queries were sent to my AS engine, right? The Vertipack engine. That's because I have all queries running. I'm tracing this and you can see there's my DAX queries. So when you're using a slicer, just a list of values, it's gonna send DAX queries back to the engine. In addition to the DAX queries, it is going to require a visual render and it will be a visual that's in a queue that's gonna attribute to the other bucket in Performance Analyzer. And so what I've done, as we go through these iterations, I created a little spreadsheet. And so for this particular one, executions is not delayed, it happens on load and it adds to visual and other. So that's the first one. On the second one, I've converted the list into a dropdown. So we're gonna go to external tools, launch DAX Studio, choose all queries, go to view, performance analyzer, start recording. So now just switch to the page. It just contains 2 slices that have been changed to dropdowns. So here we go. And you can see, this is interesting. I do see both of the slices in Performance Analyzer, but I don't see anything sent to the analysis services engine. If I expand the slicer out on both of these, you'll see that I do have some visual display because they're visuals. It adds to the other bucket because it adds to the queue of all the things that need to happen, but I don't have to incur the DAX cost, which is a good thing. The only time I incur the DAX cost when I'm using the dropdown is guess when. So let's clear this out. Click the dropdown and boom. So now I can see the DAX came through and I can see the DAX was sent here. So let's go to our spreadsheet. So you do incur other, but the execution is delayed. So I think right now I prefer to use a dropdown, even though I still get visual and other, I don't incur the cost of the DAX until I actually click that dropdown. That's pretty nice, right? So we're moving in the right direction. So if no one ever interacts with that slicer, I never pay the cost for the DAX. Pretty cool. So the next scenario, I've oriented the slices into ranges and you'll see what I'm talking about. So let's go ahead and launch DAX Studio, turn on Performance Analyzer. So these are ranges. This is like the between and the minimum and the maximum. So I'll switch. You'll see all 3 come through, which is interesting. So I get DAX and I get visual display and the other bucket for all of them, but I only see 1 evaluates into the engine. engine. And that's because each one of these are exactly the same, doing the same thing. You use both values in the between, but in the less than or equal to or the greater than, you only use the minimum or the maximum. So it uses the exact same expressions to provide the data for all three of these. Now I had three different values that I were using across these slices. You would see three different measures, but it's just a min max for each one. So this one is exactly like if I was using just the list slicer. It executes on load and it incurs the visual and the other buckets in my performance analyzer. So that's the first three. And that was all on the page, a slicer list, a slicer dropdown, and a slicer range, whether it's greater than, equal to, or between. Let's move to the slicer panel. Adam did a video on the slicer panel. If you haven't watched that video, you should go check it out. It's probably one of our most popular videos here on GynaQ. How does it behave? Let me show you. Let's do all the things. So I have performance analyzer running now, and I have DAX tracing what's gonna happen. And the slicer panel, it's collapsed, and I have just a regular list slicer. So you can see when I switch, the only thing that I'm incurring the cost for is the button that's there. Now what happens when I expand this out? Because these slicers are list slicers, I have to pay the cost for those slicers immediately upon expansion. But in addition to that, I'm also paying the cost for visual and other for all the objects that you use to create that slicer panel. I'm not gonna do a demonstration of using the range slicers because it's going to be exactly like the list slicer. So using the slicer panel though, I do delay the execution. So I'm going to give it a full X for the execution of the DAX, but for visual and other, I'm going to give it a half a X because if no one ever opens the slicer panel, I don't incur the cost. Maybe I'll give both of them a half. So in the next one, I'm going to look at a slicer panel that has dropped down. So I got performance analyzer running. I got the trace running using DAX Studio. I'm going to go ahead and switch the page just like before when I had the slicer panel with the list slicer. I only incur the cost for the button, but watch this when I expand this out. The slicers and all the objects that I need, they appear in Performance Analyzer. Nothing appears in DAX Studio. If I expand out the slicer, you can see there's no DAX or anything in any of the items that appear in Performance Analyzer. So that's a good thing. But if I expand it out, then I pay the cost. So for this one, I'm gonna still give it other, but I'm gonna say the execution is completely delayed here. I'm still in favor of the slicer and the dropdown because it completely delays the execution and it doesn't include additional costs for all the objects needed to create like this custom slicer panel. So I'm still going to say you choose a dropdown if you want to do filtering on a report as opposed to list items. Now, if you have too many dropdowns, that's a whole different story, but you've got a couple of more scenarios. Let me show you. So now to the filter panel. So with this one, the filter panel is completely collapsed. You won't see the filter pane, so this right here, when I switch. So we're gonna switch over to this page. Nothing happens, no other, nothing appears in the performance analyzer. So am I paying a cost for other and visual rendering and it's just not being captured? Not quite sure, but this is a positive direction already. It's beating out everything. Let's expand the filter pane. Still nothing in performance analyzer, nothing going out to the VertiPath, no visual rendering, no other. This is really positive. Now let's see what happens when I interact with one of these. So I'm gonna click this, boom. Nothing here, something in DAX Studio in the trace, no other a visual. This is pretty promising. So Carrie may be on to something, not just from the perspective of the filter pane provides consistency, but it may be the most optimal from a performance perspective. Now, this is kind of contradictory. Performance Analyzer is not showing a DAX query, but DAX Studio is showing a DAX query. So I know I'm incurring the cost of running the DAX query. Am I incurring any visual rendering or any other, you know, from the performance analyzer perspective? Is anything being added when I have other visuals? Am I adding to the queue? Not quite sure because I don't know, but at least from the testing that I've done, it looks like a collapsed filter pane is the leader right now. So let's see what happens. Filters pane is already expanded, but I have a few filters here. When I switch to this page, nothing executed at all. It didn't send anything to DAX Studio, no other, no visual, nothing. So let's see what happens when I interact with this. Ah, so it sends some to the AS engine, but I still have no visual or other. Whether the filter pane is expanded or collapsed, it doesn't look like I'm incurring any type of cost, visual, other, DAX, until I truly interact with the slicer. I gotta give this one the exact same rating that I gave the other one. So we kind of have a tie right now. The last scenario that I wanna touch on is when I switch the filter type from basic to advanced. Let me show you. So everything's set up, performance analyzer is running, DAX Studio is tracing, and I'm gonna switch here. I'm gonna expand the filters pane. Nothing. If I expand this out, wow, look at there. Still nothing. If I had additional visuals on the page and I put something in, we would see queries come through. So honestly, if you really want to get the most performance out of your filtering or slicing, whatever you want to call it, you want to use the filters pane. Put your filters in the filters pane, switch from the basic filter type to the advanced filter type. Not always the best option, but it doesn't look like anything really happens in the advanced until you actually completely interact with it. So if I come here, this is state province. So I put in like GE, click apply filter, nothing happens here, nothing happens there. Even though I'm trying to interact with this particular table, it still does nothing. Now, if there were visuals on the page, obviously I would see something, but definitely looks like it performs better than the other ones. So Carrie, Johnny, Ed, thanks so much for the great conversation. There's probably a million other scenarios that you can think of, and I would love to get your reaction, your comments, you know, all these different scenarios, and provide feedback to the video. You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you're first time visiting Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.